Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. So in today's tutorial, what we have told you previously that today we are going to learn on font matching. That means this is the font that is actually being used into your website template. But when we try to implement this font into our website, what we see, this is the font family that we are originally getting in back from our site. Now the problem is, this is actually a system defined font. That means this is the common font that is inbuilt to every system for Windows. And anytime, whenever we do not mention any kind of particular font format into our web project, then it will execute the default font format that it has been instructed to. So all we have to do, we have to match this font. That means the font that has been provided into our template, what we see here is this is the font that we are actually using on. And we have to match this font to our project. But before that, there are some vital issues. Those have to be taken care of before we start making any kind of font formatting. So let's get back to our project first. In the stylesheet.css, first of all, make some quick amendments. This is the parent div tagline holder. Now we are going to revert back any kind of height that has been provided to it. So all we are going to do, we are commenting out those height section. All those heights, those were attributed to this tagline holder and its associate child divs. So let's comment it out. This is, my friend, this is known as the CSS commenting. So the necessity of this commenting is that whenever you are providing this kind of stuffs ahead of any instruction or any syntax, then what it does, it just nullifies all the effects that could have been done by that particular instruction. So in this case, as we are commenting out this height 100 pixels, that means from now on there won't be any height that should be executed in this parent div, which is known as dot tagline holder. So what we are doing here, we are just commenting out any kind of height that is associated to this particular parent div known as tagline holder. So here's the first height that we have got over here, and the next height, the next child div over here is tagline holder first children logo, and the height of 100 pixels is also assigned over here. So what we need here to comment it out again, same in case of the second child div. And then comes the next. So all the three child divs and the parent divs, in these divs, the heights are now nullified. The effect of height that had been instructed here had been nullified. Now we are getting back to our project, but before that, all we need to do, we need to provide some kind of padding over here. That is, we are providing a padding bottom. So we are providing this particular instruction. Now this padding bottom attribute has been provided over here. Now we are just saving this page, stylesheet.css, getting back to our project and revert. And we see now that all the heights, those has been provided, those heights are now nullified. For this extreme divs, that is the logo box and the contact us box, these two boxes, those are showing, those are executing a property of 20 pixels padding from the bottom end. Now in case of this middle content, which is known as the tagline content over here, this content is now aligning into its extreme left position. So all we need to do, first of all, making this text alignment to center. So what we need to do, get back to stylesheet.css and provide here another syntax such as text align center. Control S, go back to your project, reload, nothing happens. Sorry, we forgot to provide this separator over here. So I think you are now aware of this fact that why to provide this separator. Instead, no such properties will be executed from beyond, from where you have made that error or that mistake. So be careful to provide a separator each time whenever you are providing a property or an attribute to a particular class name. Just press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and you see now this time this tagline is now aligning at this central position of this web page and of course of this div. Now get back to your project, first of all come back to index.html and see over here where is the tagline. Here is the tagline, and this comes under this tag which is known as h1. So this h1 in turn is coming under this class name or selector name, which is known as tagline holder tagline content. So all we need to do, first of all copy this class name, get back to style sheet, and here this is the class that has been created with the same name as tagline holder tagline content. So what we are going to do over here, first of all provide the same class name over here, and then you are actually customizing the h1 tag that is coming under this class name. So now provide this h1 tag, customize this h1 tag and provide attributes for it. So what we are going to do over here, we are now customizing this thing. Now all we need to do, we have to take care of the font size first. So this is the font size. Suppose we are assuming it to be at a size of 30 pixels. Another thing that comes over here is known as font weight. Suppose you want to make your font more weighty, so all you need to do, you may write here bold, or you may write here any amount that comes into this, such as this one, 700, whatever you wish. If you wish to change the style, the stylings of font element that is present into your website, then all you have to do, you have to provide this attribute over here which is known as font style, and you are setting it to italic. If you want to make a certain space from the top and from the bottom, that means if you want to appear your text into the central, into vertically central position of your div, then all you need to do, you need to provide a particular line height to that project, and it is make here the font size, the line height as for say 60 pixels. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and you see now that your tagline content, it has been now turned into an italic version. It is now bold, and it is aligning of course in the central position, and it is aligning in a vertical middle zone of the of that particular div. So providing the line height here actually means you are providing a particular space between two successive lines. Now as you are using a single line element over here, so all it is doing over here is increasing the spacing from the top and from the bottom, aligning the content directly into the middle of your div. So this is the usage of line height attribute. Another thing that comes into action is known as font family. So if you provide here font family, that means you are now specifying the family of this font. What is it? Is it a sans serif, or it is a cursive, or it is a fantasy? What kind of font family it is actually using? So this is the font that actually I am using over here. So all I need to do is to rename this font, copy it, copy the name of this font file over here. Now get back to your project, and within inverted column, all you have to do, you have to press this font family. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, reload, and you see that now the font family has been changed. It is now changed into Dorial. From its system defined font family, it is now changed into this user defined font family. Another thing over here, if you view our template that has been awarded to us, we will see that this is a normal styling font what we are practicing over here, but this is an italic version. So all we need to do, again we need to comment out this section which is known as font style italic, and of course we are reducing the font weight over here. We don't need such font weight, it's a huge one. So get back to your project, reload, and you see now this font styling, now it is almost matching to the template that we are using. So we are going to keep these changes that we have made so far. All these things are right on track, and we are getting a pretty closer display or execution of the project into our browser. But there is a minor problem that we are not caring so far for the time being. this kind of font is now installed into my computer that I have downloaded from the internet. But it is not sure and certain that the same font will be present on your machine, because this is not actually a system defined font. So what we are going to do, because what we are seeing over here, this font, as this font has been installed into my machine, that is why you may have a preview of it into my web browser. But what we are talking about, general display into any machine worldwide. But in that case, that won't be a wise enough thing that you just mention a particular font name over here and you just leave it. In that case, what we have to do practically, we have to download this font from the internet first, and then we have to generate the corresponding codes in every format available in the market. And then we have to copy those things into our CSS folder, and then we have to make it organized into our style sheet, such as this font matches to every computer. Whenever someone opens this website, the necessary files to execute this font family downloads into client's machine, and then this font is visible to everybody as it is now visible to us. So what we have to do, first of all, we have to generate this font. But before that, what we have to do, you have to install it from the internet, and that is what exactly we are going to do. The procedure is very simple.